Let's be honest, most Unreal Engine render tutorials are still using old settings, random console commands, or stuff that doesn't even affect the final render. So today, we're fixing all of that. This is the Unreal Engine 5 render guide for 2026, unless there's new update for Movie Render Queue. And these settings are based on real testing, not recycled advice. I'm going to show you the only settings that actually matter, and how to instantly level up your renders with cleaner lighting, sharper edges, and proper motion blur. While this video isn't sponsored, I do want to let you know there's a Black Friday sale going on from Liardi's Studio. You can get 47 premium packs worth $6,627 for just $39. Just make sure to use the BF60 discount code before you check out. The link is in the description. Let's get started by opening your level sequence. I mean, if you were looking for Movie Render Queue Guide, then it's probably enabled on your end. Since I love wasting your time like every other YouTuber, let me actually show you how to enable it. Actually, I just want some watch time. Anyway, go to Edit, then Plugins, and search for Movie Render Queue, and here enable Movie Render Queue and Movie Render Queue Additional Passes. And then restart your engine. Now click on the Movie Render Queue button and it'll open the MRQ window. From here, just click on Unsaved Config. Here we have the JPG sequence first, which is basically for low quality renders, so we're going to delete that. Instead, we'll add an EXR sequence, which is the industry standard. EXR renders in 16-bit and it stores way more color and lighting information than an 8-bit JPG or PNG. Now let's add anti-aliasing, then game overrides. We also need to add high resolution, then color output, and the last thing we'll add is console variables. Before we change any settings, let's set the output location and then the output resolution. I'm going with 3840 by 2160, which is 4K. If you want, you can push it to 8K, but only do that if you actually need an 8K render. Next, go to color output, open the mist dropdown, and enable disable tone curve. What does this do? When you disable the tone curve, Unreal stops applying its built-in color curve to your render. That means you'll get a clean, linear image with no extra contrast or color shifts added by the engine. It's perfect if you want consistent color grading later in post. Now for anti-aliasing. If you're rendering a still image, you should use spatial samples. That will give you the cleanest, sharpest result. But if your animation has movement and you want really smooth, clean motion blur, then you should increase the temporal sample count instead. For example, take a look at these two renders. The left one is rendered with temporal samples, and the right one is rendered with spatial samples. And yes, there's no motion blur on the right side, but that doesn't mean spatial samples remove motion blur. That only happened here because the motion blur settings were low for this specific render. And if your motion blur in the post-process volume is set to 1 and you render the same frame using spatial samples, you can see it does add motion blur on the car, just not as good or as smooth as the temporal samples render. But here's the important part. If your motion blur is set to 0 and you try to render with temporal samples, it's not going to magically create motion blur. So always double check your motion blur values in the post-process volume or your camera before rendering. And default motion blur is better than setting it to 1. Or sometimes it can give you an error after render for using high sample count. For example, I rendered with 32 temporal samples. I don't even know why I showed all this, but hopefully it helps someone out there. Now let's get back to settings. And since my scene has no need of motion blur, I'm going to set the spatial sample count to 32. Next, check override anti-aliasing and leave it on none. If you want your render to be faster, you can switch it to TSR, but for maximum quality, none is the safest option. Now enable both options and set the value to 128 or 64. If you also want to set a value for engine warmup, disable use camera cut for warmup and enter the same number. Why is engine warmup helpful? Warmup lets Unreal run several frames before the actual render starts, so all the heavy systems, lumen, shadows, reflections, GI, temporal history, have time to stabilize. This removes flickers, lighting pops, noisy first frames, and unfinished lumen data. So your render starts already fully warmed up, giving you a cleaner first frame and more stable lighting. And now let's go to console variables, and we're only adding two console variables this time. First, add r.screenPercentage and set the value to 150. You can lower it or increase it depending on your machine's specs. And let's add one more variable. Type r.raytracing.nanite.mode and set the value to 1. I just noticed while editing that the value didn't change and I kept recording it, so make sure you set it to 1, not 0. Now everything is done in Movie Render Queue, so go ahead and click Accept. Also, you don't have to change anything in Game Overrides or High Resolution. Game Overrides is basically a safety layer. It forces Unreal to ignore things like scalability settings, preview mode settings, or editor quality limitations. It makes sure your render uses full quality, even if your viewport is set to low or medium. High resolution is mainly for tiling renders, where Unreal renders your image in multiple tiles to create super high resolution outputs without running out of memory. Also, don't touch the high resolution tile count unless you really need to. And if you increase the number of tiles, it can cause issues with bloom, lens flares, depth of field, and other screen space effects. Because each tile is rendered separately and Unreal can't blend those effects perfectly across tile borders. If you're rendering normal 4K or 8K, you don't need to touch it. And if you want my preset, I've added the download link in the video description. Now, if you're ready to start the render, just click Render Local. And if you're using all these settings and your render still flickers, has noise, or looks like it was made on a potato, that usually means the scene itself isn't optimized. Movie Render Queue can't magically fix bad lighting, low quality lumen settings, or a messy scene setup. Render settings only work if your scene is designed properly. That part is on you. If you want a full video on optimizing lumen scenes the right way, drop a comment and become a YouTube member before requesting anything, because I'm not doing free tech support for people who ignore their post-process volume. Thanks for learning. Love you all, even the ones who skip to the end. Also, let me quickly show you how to use that discount code on the Black Friday sale bundle. When you're on checkout page, scroll all the way down to the end. Here, enter the discount code BF60 and hit apply. The price will drop from $99.99 USD to $39.99 USD. If you're in India, you'll also have to pay GST on top of that. But in most countries, the tax amount will be different. All right, guys, that's it for now. Check it out while the offer is still active. Take care, and I'll see you in the next one.